Christmas is coming early as I share with you my first impressions on Noble Otter the night before. Coming right. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Lathercock channel, where we talk about all things wet shaving. I'm your host, John, and for today's shave, I'll be sharing with you my first impressions on a holiday-themed scent, and that is Noble Otter the night before. This soap has some very festive label artwork here and packaging. It's actually in a red tub, and everything from the side labels to kind of just the little bit of shine you get from the background here and the otter's nose. Just really well done, matching aftershave here. Really easy to tell that Noble Otter is really producing some of the best labels in the artisan soap game. Let's crack the top open and give you a quick impression of just what the soap smells like off the tub. You can see here, unused. So what I'm getting is actually not a very obvious holiday or Christmas themed scent. It's a very clean, woody scent that I would say probably lies around maybe a 3.5 or 4 out of 10. That's within the tub. So I am thinking this is going to open up a little bit more. We'll get into the scent notes and all that good stuff. But let me show you what else we're going to use for today's shave. First up for the razor, we're going with the Razor Rock Game Changer 0.84. And this is loaded with a Pole Silver Super Iridium blade. And for the brush, we're going with the Carnivus Richardson Titanium. This is loaded with a Decoration Grooming B6 Knot. But before we move on, if you like this video and the other videos on this channel, you can do me a huge favor by hitting that like button and becoming a subscriber if you haven't done so already. Every little bit helps as I'm trying to hit that 1,000 sub mark, so thank you in advance. All right, so here we go in with the face lather. One very handy thing is that the scent notes are listed right on the tub. So the notes on the night before include pink peppercorn, balsam fir, mistletoe, rosemary, amber, sandalwood, vanilla, frankincense, and myrrh. Now upon lathering, the scent strength, I would say, off the tub, it was definitely lighter. It probably moves up at most, you know, half a point or 1 point more. I feel pretty confident to say that this is probably a 4 out of 10 as far as scent strength once lathered up. All right, so not too much talking while I was lathering today. I have to say I'm pretty happy with kind of this creamy lather I was able to whip up today. This is 2 days worth of beard growth, so not crazy amount, but you can see, you can see it faintly. I have to say that committing to only using these Decoration knots, I think it's paying off. As I mentioned in a previous video, I was getting maybe inconsistent or, you know, thinner lathers. I just wasn't loading enough, wasn't agitating enough, all of the above, honestly. And I don't know, I think I'm quite happy with our results today. So we're gonna go with this. All right, so here we go in with the Razor Rock Game Changer 0.84. And right off the bat, since I didn't get to talk too much about the scent during that initial lathering phase, let me just go in with the cons of this scent. And I would say the scent strength, I would have liked a little bit more. It did open up, the scent opened up a little bit more after lathering it, but again, you know, not too much more as far as strength. I did say woody and clean. I would say that the balsam fir presents itself a little bit more, but overall, it's not really a Christmassy scent to me at all. Definitely one of the cases where on paper, well, first, you know, all the notes I listed off before are ones I would like. Nothing, you know, no offender to me. Certain notes I do look out for, like vetiver, I like it, but I'm wary of how it plays with other notes. Certain floral notes like carnation, geranium are very, very hit or miss for me. And so there's nothing that was glaring to me when I looked at what made up this scent. So unfortunately, this kind of suffers in the same way as my feelings became for Noble Otter Roar, where, you know, the concept and the label artwork for a particular soap was better than the actual scent. So I'm a little bummed to say that, and, you know, also take that with a grain of salt that this is a first impressions video. So those are the cons. The pros of The Night Before is this could be a very easy daily driver. It's scented for sure. I'm not implying that this is unscented. That's how low scented it is. But it's for folks who like more subtle scents, more understated scents, I think this would be in your wheelhouse. And the fact that it doesn't, I mean, it's got a super Christmassy label, but the scent itself, you can use it also every day. So it's not overpowering and a very clean, accessible scent. So, you know, it might not look like it on paper, it might not look like it based on the packaging, but this could be a very good everyday soap if you're looking for something a little simple. Again, something clean, woody, and then maybe it's a bonus that it's a really cool Christmas label. We're gonna take a quick pause in the shave to announce the giveaway winner for the tub of A&E Peach and Cognac. So let's bring up the spinner. So congratulations to Banaka's Life for winning this tub of A&E Peaches and Cognac. Banaka, you can contact me via Facebook or email me at latherhog@gmail.com and claim your prize. I do want to thank everyone who shared their most hated Christmas or holiday themed song. I really got a good laugh from some of the answers. Also, some great stories attached to why some of these were your hated songs. So thank you guys, everyone who entered or who shared the story. It was greatly appreciated. You can go back to the Barbershop de los Muertos video if you want to see some of the replies that I got. Again, thank you to all the participants in this giveaway. I might try to squeeze one more in before the Christmas holiday. Keep your eyes out for that. Okay, so now back to the shave, lathering up for the second pass. Now the funny thing about theme soaps, I don't really have too many blatantly Christmas themed. So the funny thing is when I ordered the set for The Night Before, another soap that you'll see in a upcoming video, possibly the next video, is Barrister and Man's Oh Delight. And that one is, inspired by Turkish Delight, well known for appearing in The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, and The Chronicles of Narnia. I don't think I've ever had Turkish Delight. I just know it can be quite sweet and is a fruity kind of dessert. One thing I did notice towards the end of my first pass is the lather that kind of is unused by my neck here was starting to dry out. So that tells me that I can add more water still to this lather. Granted, I had no problem whatsoever in the first pass. The razor just glided, no problem. You know, solid soap base formula here. All right, so here we go against the grain. One thing I wanted to mention was, in my last video, I covered Madame Soap's Mood Indigo, and I'm recording this on Monday evening after the soap has after the re-release has already dropped, and I'm really happy to say that even like 5 hours after the drop, possibly even right now, I haven't checked after I put my kids down to sleep, but there was still inventory. So for those who have tried to get Mammoth in the past and have seen them, you know, fly off the shelves within a minute or minutes, those days might be behind us. And it sounds like Ben from Mammoth says there's more inventory coming, that Mood Indigo and some other scents are gonna be more readily available, so that's great. I know a lot of people's budgets are maxed out because of holiday shopping, so this is a great development. Again, I'm hoping this removes that hype brand label. People can appreciate it for what it is, and again, Mood Indigo, one of my all-time favorite scents from Mammoth and in general from the world of wet shaving. So the fact that more folks can experience it, I know it's not gonna be for everyone, but the fact that they can give it a shot makes me extremely happy. So congratulations, Ben, on a great launch. One nice thing I found with like a two days worth of beard growth, and then the 0.84, which is not super aggressive, but it's more efficient than the 0.68 plate. I don't usually need to do the cleanup pass normally. And the times I've tried chasing that, you know, BBS close shave, I just wind up irritating the heck out of my neck. So we're gonna stop here at two passes. I'm gonna rinse off and we'll check out the scent in the aftershave. All right, so in the performance department, this soap, no issue whatsoever. It's quite nice. Post-shave here. It's funny, the cons that I mentioned for the night before really might not be a con, depending on your preference as far as scent strength, and if you want a kind of a deliberate Christmas scent, or you just want something enjoyable. The scent definitely comes out much, you know, much more clearly in the aftershave here. Kind of a nice rich warmness to the amber that I think is really, really in the background, almost non-detectable in the soap. That amber is really nice in this aftershave. So I'm liking this much more. I would say this is more closer to the scent strength in the aftershave. Definitely closer to 5, maybe even a 5.5. Oh, that's too bad. I really like the scent in the aftershave, I'd say. I mean, and that might be the case for probably most soaps where you get unencumbered by a soap base. But in particular, that note of amber really, really pops. I don't know, there's something warm, inviting, really enjoyable. I mean, hopefully you can tell by my tone. It's a scent note I really enjoy. Especially in fall and winter scents, it adds something cozy about it. I can see why this was pushed forward as the Christmas themed scent. So, aftershave, big win. Soap, I think soap is it's going to get the job done. But obviously the scent did not wow me there. But I think the scent and the aftershave really has redeemed this entire experience for me. And of course, I want to hear from you guys as well. So with the holidays coming up, do you have a special, you know, soap, maybe even a special razor or brush that you want to use? Get that color coordination going. Let me know in the comments below what you have set up for a Christmas or holiday shave. And so that brings us to the end of the video. I want to thank you guys so much, as always, for the time that you give to watch the videos. I do hope that the information is helpful. If you ever have any questions on the products you see used in this video or any video, don't be a stranger. That's what the comment section is for. I really do enjoy hearing from you guys, even if it's just to say, hey, what's up? Or to answer a question. It's that interaction that keeps me going. So I do want to thank you guys for your continued support. I hope you have a great day, and I'll catch you next time. Take care.